Hey y'all, it's Bailey, and welcome back to the channel for what's going to be a quick review of the new Hourglass Stick Foundation. These guys are called the Vanish Seamless Finish Foundation, and they sent me two shades. I have Ivory, which is the lighter, and Warm Ivory, which is naturally a little bit warmer, a little bit deeper, but not by much. And then they also sent me a brush. I don't know if this launched with the foundation collection or if this has always been around, but naturally they recommend this to apply, so I'll be talking about that as well. And basically, these are supposed to be stick foundations with the coverage of a concealer, the lightweight feel of a powder, I believe, fluidity of a liquid foundation, I think is what, you know, kind of the bullet point said that when they sent this to me. So if you're not new to the channel, you probably know I loved Makeup Forever's HD or Ultra HD stick foundation. I only don't have it here to compare like physically against these today because it was in a recent empties video. It had been sitting in my empties pile for forever. So I had to let it go. But I said I wasn't gonna be repurchased until fall winter because even though it stays on me in spring and summer, it does give me a really beautiful kind of lit from within glow. But on my combination skin, it lasts all day. So knowing that I'm now out of stick foundation, I was really hoping that these could kind of stand up to that, see how they compare. So I'm gonna be talking about how they compare in this video as well. It would probably also help to talk about the kind of skin I have, just so as a means of comparison when I talk about how this wears on my skin. I have combo skin. It is prone to acne, less so now that I'm older, but faithfully once a month I will get hormonal breakouts around my chin and then sometimes randomly in my T-zone around my nose. Just, you know, random pimple, whatever. And so with that can come redness. So I got some stuff that I occasionally like to cover, and I just in general love a fuller finish foundation. So this sounded like it was right up my alley. For starters, you get 0.25 ounces of products for $46. 46 bucks is pretty in line with what the rest of the Hourglass, which is a somewhat luxury. I mean, it's not super, super high end, but it's, you know, it's not mid, whatever. it's up there, but it's still on par with what you would find elsewhere in the Hourglass collection. And there are something like 26 shades in this collection. So it's a really nice broad shade. There are shades lighter than those that I have. There are many, many shades deeper. It looks like there's a really great range here, but I can't say it's right for my skin type. And I'll tell you why. I've applied this I've been testing this for about, let's see, I think I got this a week ago. Been wearing it every day ever since, trying it with different combinations of primer, setting spray, nothing, etc. And it just doesn't work for my skin. It applies flawlessly, beautifully. I'll show a demo here of me applying. The way that I use both of these shades is Ivory kind of in the center of my face to highlight, and then Warm Ivory around the perimeter, anywhere where I, not contour, like it's not that deep, but just any, you know, anywhere where I want subtle differences in shade versus light. That's kind of how I use these all over my face. And then I buff them in using the brush that they provided. And right off the bat, I really loved the way it looked. I definitely feel like it gives almost concealer level coverage. Like it is a very full coverage. It's very lightweight. I would say even more lightweight than the Makeup Forever. And it blends like a fluid, like really, really easy to blend. It's super creamy and not cakey. But I do find that you can go overboard with this. The first time I used it, I went way overboard with the amount I was using, and all throughout the day, I just felt like I saw it coming off on my hands, on my clothes. It was kind of caking up in spots, and so I wouldn't say it's a buildable coverage foundation. Like really, don't use it sparingly, but you can go overboard, so just be very aware of that as you're testing or trying for the first time. It's a little bit more finicky for me in that way as far as stick foundations go. Still, the way it looked when it first applied, I was sold. I was like, I love this, it's beautiful, let's see how it wears throughout the day. And that's where things got a little bit wonky. So the first time I wore this, I didn't have any primer on. I really like to test my foundations without primer, without setting spray, without setting powder. I like to see how the foundation itself wears because I do have a foundation. It is the J. Manuel, this guy. You're probably sick of hearing me talking about it, but it's now my Holy Grail foundation because it wears flawlessly. It's relatively lightweight. I wouldn't say it's as lightweight as the Hourglass, but it lasts all day on me without setting powder, without a primer. And so this is kind of the bar for me. So I tried the Hourglass at first without any help. No setting powder, setting spray, primer, any of that. And like I said, I did apply it a little bit too heavily. So not only did I see it coming off, I found it kind of clumping up and caking up elsewhere on my face. And this is on, I mean, it's on my normal skincare routine. So I have moisturized, I put my SPF on, I have like a primed face otherwise. And so typically foundations perform well on top of that. And this just didn't. It really developed a lot of shine in my T-zone. It broke apart in drier patches on my skin, which I can sometimes get kind of on the perimeter of my face. and I just was not impressed with the wear at all. So they recommend using it with their Hourglass Mineral Primer, which has never worked for me. I didn't really like it. And so I just figured, why not? They're formulated to go together. Let's give it a try. Applied that underneath, no setting powder, no setting spray, and I did notice a better performance. And then the next time I wore it, I used not only this primer, but also a setting spray. I've really been liking, where is it? This Laura Geller Spackle Mist. And only then was I really able to get it to a place where I didn't feel like it was breaking apart and developing a lot of shine on my skin. And I just, like I said, having discovered my personal Holy Grail liquid foundation back there, I don't know that in addition to having to buy this and using the primer and using setting spray, like, I have a foundation that works really well without all that kind of stuff, and it gives me a similar flawless wear. I will say, or I said it before, that the Hourglass stick has a very, very light feel to the skin. Like, it really does not feel like you're wearing anything, but to me none of that really matters if it doesn't last on my skin throughout the day. Additionally, one thing I want to point out is the cost per ounce, I suppose. Like I said, you get 0.25 for 46 with the Hourglass, and you get almost double that, 0.4 or 0.44 in the Makeup Forever for 42, I think. And so, and I go through both of these, both stick, because they're so creamy, they're so easy to apply. I have already, yeah, it's this one. I've already made a serious dent in the ivory shade in that they've provided to me, and so I just know I'm gonna burn through this stuff like crazy, just like I did with the Makeup Forever. But with the Makeup Forever, you get double the product. So overall, this is not a foundation that I would recommend if, like me, you have combination skin and you tend to have those issues with foundation breaking apart instead of your face or clinging to those dry patches. This just did not work for me, and when I finally got it to a place where it did, I felt like I just had other foundations that could do the job better without all of the extra stuff. If you're looking for a stick foundation, I still recommend the Makeup Forever HD. This brush, however, is really nice. I will say, I personally love a good kabuki. If you watch my recent, like, favorite brush kind of overview guide that I recently put out, you will know I love a good kabuki to apply, like a nice dense fluffy blending brush to apply foundation. This one in particular is nice because it's small enough to fit right here. Like, this is the area where I either go too far back and I get at my hairline and then I'm having to try and get it out, or I get it in my brows, which is a little less problematic, but it's a little bit more, or a little less cumbersome to kind of apply your foundation around the face. I personally already had brushes that I use to accomplish the job just as well, namely the IT Cosmetics, and I forget what this is called, Heavenly Luxe. It's like powder and bronzer brush. This is what I mentioned in that video. But I think the prices are comparable. The Hourglass brush is $46, so if you think this one might be a little too big and too all over the place on your face, I do think this would be a good alternative. So I don't necessarily think you need to own both of them, but if you are looking for a good buffing foundation brush, this is another great one to look into, just because the size is nice and compact and it buffs things out really beautifully. I've even used it with other liquid foundations, and it does exactly the same job as it did with the stick. So was actually really impressed with the brush. But like I said, if you own this or the other brush I recommended in that video, I don't think you need to own those and this too. So that's it for me, guys. Overall, I can't really recommend this foundation to you if you have combo skin, just given my experiences with it. The brush is not so bad. Would definitely recommend you check it out if you're looking for a good buffing foundation brush. But if you have dry or just another skin type other than my combo acne prone skin, definitely go check out other people's reviews. That's the beauty of, you know, the beauty community here on YouTube, is that those videos probably exist. This might be a great foundation for you. I just can't personally speak to that from my experience. So go check those out. But otherwise, thank you guys so much for watching. Really hope this video was useful. And let me know what you think. If you've tried this foundation in the comments, if you have your own favorite stick foundation, let me know what that is in the comments. I would love to hear that. But besides that, thank you guys so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and I will catch you in my next video. Bye, guys.